Last night's game, biggest disappointment to me was a 2-0 lead on home ice, and they couldn't hold on to it.
You said it. The shorthanded goal, I think, was a big deflator for us. Again, when they scored that shorthanded goal, you could almost see the momentum completely shift. Fernie went back on their heels, and we stopped skating. They came on and attacked us hard, and I think they outshot us something like 17-11 in that second period. But again, that second goal that tied the game up for Muskies, I should say, that really changed the momentum of the game big time.
By the way, welcome to Ghost Rider Hockey on Kootenai Cable. We start that off with a bang, but I really wanted to hit that point because that's not the first time we've seen that in the last handful of games. It seems the Ghost Riders have lost some of their magic on home ice. Very good team on home ice. Still are a very good record on home ice, but they come out with a game like the Bozeman game, then they come out with a game like the Minot game. The theme seems to be inconsistency right now. This team knows how it can play, but doesn't always do that.
Yeah, you said it. Inconsistency is the word, and the boys have to realize this. We're getting close to crunch time now. Every win is important. I think when we went on that major win streak in late November through to December before Christmas, and to get to up to 500 hockey, they realize, oh, it's not that easy. It's not that hard. Well, it is that hard. We have to work every game. It's a full 60 minutes of hockey. You can't take any opponent lightly, and everybody that's above us that we play in this arena, we have to beat them, because eventually, as long as the season goes, as long as you go in the playoffs, we have to win on home ice.
Something that I asked Todd Jones about once, and he downplayed it a little bit, but in my head it's starting to look more and more like it, is that 500 mark was a psychological barrier. They got to that. Now they can't push past it.
Yeah, you said it. We got to get above that 500 barrier, especially before the end of the season. It's a major confidence boost. You don't want to remain at 500. You don't want the opposition thinking that they're going to come into our arena and steal 2 points from us. 2 points in the playoffs, it could be a one victory away from being eliminated, or a victory moving on to the next round in the playoffs. We have to get physical. We have to really start skating and not stop skating. When you got opponents like Muskies coming in, who's a big team, but they don't check hard. It's obvious. They got probably the biggest team in the league, and they don't force their size on us. We're a young team, we're a small team, but we're a very aggressive team, and it's time that we start using it on home ice.
And again, Minot missing their leading scorer tonight, David Ludvik, probably won't be here. I don't imagine he got across the border.
No.
Juha Kilhoma was in the lineup. He just wearing a different number now, which caught me off guard. But the Muskies obviously aren't going to be as dangerous without their top scorer. And the Ghost Riders, if they can get off to a good start again tonight, are going to have to. It's going to have to come down to a good start. But this time, they really got to hold on to it. If they woke up and looked at the standings this morning, or if they have access to that this early, they'll know that Great Falls did us a favor. They beat Bismarck.
Yeah.
Kimber did us a favor. They beat Bozeman. We didn't lose any ground last night, but we're darn lucky we didn't.
No, it's about time. They got to realize this. Let's get that 4 points in this series right now. Get up and get in there from Friday and Sunday. Let's get those 4 points. Moves us closer to Bismarck, moves us closer to Kimberly, like you said. But it's time to really bear down and understand this, boys. It's a team effort. Nobody and no individual is going to win this on their own. They have to remain focused. They have to come out hitting. And the thing is, it's a 60-minute game. It's not a 40-minute game. It's not a 50-minute game. It's 60 minutes. Another thing that the Riders are going to have to do, score on the power play. We scored on our power play last night. Godfrey got a beautiful goal. If we can get an extra 5% on our power play, it could actually make the difference in the playoff. They have to bear down, concentrate in practice time like you do in game time, and practice hard and play hard.
Just judging by who I see standing down by the dressing room now, looks like Jake Postikov won't play tonight. That means Chris Kissick will be back in the lineup. I don't know if tinkering with the fourth line is going to make a whole lot of difference, but the lineup they had in there last night is very capable of beating this Minot team, and it's got to happen tonight. We needed 4 out of 6 points minimum this weekend,
yes.
And they're going to have to get the 2 points tonight, and they're going to have to find a way to be a lot more consistent. At times last night, Minot looked like they were on the power play. The possession time last night was, I don't have a stopwatch, but I'd say it was greatly in Minot's favor in our end last night.
Oh, for sure. Once they seen us put us back on our heels, for some reason it was a psychological, we went back on our heels, we stopped skating and let them control the play. Not in our arena, not in anybody's arena. You want to control the play, force it in their zone and finish those checks. That's the whole key ingredient. Communicate, that's two things. I seen us break down on communication, not pass the puck up, or with players within 5 feet of each other, don't even do anything with the puck. They stopped it, Minot picked the puck up. You got to communicate out there. That is the key to victory, without any doubt.
Well, that's probably all we need to say about tonight. They need the 2 points to get a four out of this weekend. And with about just under 7 minutes left until game time, but just a blink here on Kootenay Cable, we'll wrap up our pregame show. And when we come back, we'll have first period action. It should be right around the corner. Welcome to Fernie Ghost Riders Hockey on Kootenay Cable. The Minot Muskies visiting again for the second game in 2 nights. 2 minute bench minor for delay of game as the Riders weren't out in time to start this game, so they were assessed a penalty. I don't know who's to blame for something like that. I know the coaches were on the bench, so I don't know whether there was a meeting going on in the locker room or what was going on there, but the Riders were not out for the start of the game, and they'll start this game shorthanded. And you want to get some momentum going, obviously, the beginning of a game, and killing off a penalty is not going to do that. But that's what they're stuck with anyway. And an icing call on the power play. Brings the faceoff down deep into Minot territory to the blocker right-hand side of Ryan S. Ghost Riders killing off this penalty. Just a minute and 33 left now. Adam Sando in his own zone. Sets up behind his own net, looking for something to set up. Aaron Degernis, 2 goals last night. Starts out of his own zone. Back to Sando. Carries up through center. Sando hits the blue line, and Pichea strips him of the puck. And Neil called, I guess they're going to say it was offside, but the puck never went over the blue line, I didn't think, so interesting call right off the bat. Juha Kilholma on the draw against Connor Hughes. Muskie start with the puck. Sando backhands it in deep into the offensive zone. Minute 12 left in the power play now. Referee Birkebile gets in the way. Palmer can't get it out. Now Godfrey loses his man, comes out front, but the puck is just sent back to the point. All the way down the ice. Sando back in his own zone with Kramer Hickey, the captain for the Muskies. Mark Palmer, Fernie captain, in on the forecheck. Now backs off. Juha Kilholma brings the puck out. Back pass to Sando. All the way up, and that's a two-line pass as Jim Gaffney took it over two lines. That leaves just 49 seconds left in the power play. So the Minot power play guilty of a two-line offside pass and an icing on the same two-minute advantage. Now Jakub Kolma for the Ghost Riders off the draw, just gets a towards the net. S stops that one easily. In behind the net is Chris Henham. Henham starts the play up, puts it through the neutral zone to Troy Wiebler. Ghost Riders initially cut it off, but now Wiebler, with a second chance, puts the puck out in front of the net, and it's swept away from the front by Adrian Chubotti. Back to pick it up is Dan Cohen. Cohen at center just lofts one in. Cullen gets to it and smacks it around the boards. Now there's a Ghost Rider down behind the net. That's Ryan Cullen as he's slow to get back to the bench. Now Jan Pichaia crashes into the boards at the other side. Now the Muskies with just 7 seconds left in the power play bring the puck to center, bank it off the sideboards. Wagman gets a stick in the way of that shooting attempt. Now the Riders, Chubotti, sees Connor Hughes. Connor Hughes, the partial breakaway, goes to the backhand, puts it out front. Palmer shoots and scores! Mark Palmer, just as the power play expired, the Ghost Riders get on the board first. Nearly a a shorthanded goal as the Riders started up ice just as the man got out of the box. Now Wagman back at his own line, banks it off the boards to Robinson. Jeremy Robinson now with 12 points in his last seven games. Connor Hughes now 10 points in his last seven. But here come the Muskies. A shot hits Ali in the face mask. Rebound was laying loose in front. And now another penalty coming up to the Ghost Riders. Looks like Connor Hughes is going to get a hooking call. And Derek Birkebeil already has the Fernie Ghost Riders down the man twice. We haven't even played 2.5 minutes of this game yet, and the Riders have been down a man already twice now. Refereeing last night by the linesman tonight, Neil, was just bloody awful. We hope Derek Birkebeil will do a better job tonight. But he's going to have to look to even it up here already, as the Riders already down 2 power plays to nothing. Johnson plays the puck behind the net to Dejanis. Back to the point of shot. Blocked by Palmer, and Palmer smacks it down the ice. S out of his net, plays it up to an open wing. Dejanis gets it there. Plays the puck cross ice to Eric Johnson. Johnson in over the blue line. 2 goals last night for Johnson. 1 an empty netter, though. I almost don't like to count empty netters. They should be a different stat for those in the standings. Now Robinson goes to the puck but can't get it out as he couldn't catch up to it. Now Johnson off the near boards. Chased by Stout. Dejanis gets in there. Stout picks it up. Rifles it along the boards. And Palmer gets it the rest of the way out. Kramer Hickey can't keep it in. Eric Johnson back inside his own line as the Muskies chased all the way back into their own end by Jeremy Robinson, who's doing all kinds of, causing all kinds of trouble in there. 1-on-3. That killed off some valuable time on the power play. Now Dejanis tries to catch up to a pass off the boards. Gets to it first. Murphy takes him out, though. That allows Wasmuth to just chip it back to the point. Now Hickey can't keep it in. It goes cross ice. Picked up there by Andy Jurek. Ali falls as he comes out of his net. 16:19 left in the first period. 46 seconds now left in the power play. Jurek back to the point of shot. Missed the net as Ali didn't need to make a move there. 16:10 left in the first period. 36 seconds left in the power play. Riders up 1-0. Muskies still control in the Fernie zone. Now a penalty coming up against Minot. They already had control of the puck once, though, and the ref didn't blow the whistle. For Mark Palmer, that is his 16th goal in the year. That's because the ref didn't follow him, man, and Minot had possession. Minot did have possession momentarily, and Birkebeil did not make the call, and that led Ryan S. to believe the penalty was against the Ghost Riders. He was coming out of the net. He even saw the Muskies play the puck. Birkebeil, the only guy in the arena who didn't. The call made nonetheless. Now Jakub Kolma. Even strength for another 9 seconds. Can't get the puck down the ice. Now a shot towards the net. Wide. Bounced off the backboards. Nearly out front. Kramer Hickey pinches down low from his defensive position. Battling with Jim Murphy. Juha Kilhoma comes out of the corner. Can't control the puck. Robbie Godfrey in there battling with him. Kilhoma finally tries to get away. The two Minot Muskies fall over each other. And now we got Jared Saylor. Two-line pass, though. Will bring the play back into Fernie territory with 1.5 minutes left in the power play. Riders on the power play now. So far, Minot 0 for 2 with the man advantage. Now the Riders get their first chance. Three of them set up behind the net. Kolma plays it back to Kyle Shane, who gets it back to Kolma, who plays it up to Chibati. Chibati brings it in and over to the blue line. Dumped in behind the net to Saylor. Saylor back to the point to Shane. A shot. S kicks that out. Rebound comes out front. Puck was still loose, but it was pushed behind the net. Now Shane keeps it at the point. Dumps the puck back in the sideboards. picked up there by Coma. Coma back to the point to Shane, a shot. Astin couldn't make that stop, and it went right through him and out the other side, but did not find the twine. Now Kyle Shane behind his own net. Out here is a defenseman on this power play. Shane brings the puck through center. Can't get around the second man, though, and the Muskies send it back down the ice with just 28 seconds left. Chibati behind his own net. Plays the puck to Connor Hughes and moves up the right wing. Hughes tips the puck in over the line. Palmer can't handle, and the puck sent back down the ice. Godfrey gives chase. Now Godfrey behind his own net. 5 seconds left on the power play. This might kill it off, though. Now Connor Hughes plays the puck up to Stout. Stout chips it to Palmer. Palmer near the line with Hughes and Robinson. Palmer cross ice pass, broken up there by Adam Sando. Now 3-on-2 the other way. Sando goes wide, gets a pass out in front, but it was to Kilhoma, who was already past the net. He tried to put a pass out front, but he couldn't get it there. Now Palmer battles along the boards with Justin Hillier. Godfrey battling with Hillier in the corner. Muskies Kilhoma behind the net, knocked down by Palmer. Another penalty coming up as Palmer knocks Kilhoma down twice. Already been 4 penalty calls in this game from Birkebeil, and we haven't played 6-7 full minutes yet. Ghost Riders shorthanded for the 3rd time tonight, and the game isn't 7 minutes old. Leading 1-0, but I don't know if they're going to be able to hold that lead, getting 3 penalties in, you know, in the first period alone, let alone the first couple of minutes. Now Ali swipes at that puck, but it goes over on top of the net. Murphy pins his man up against the boards. Muskies look like they're going to try and set something up. Back to the point now to Hickey. Down low, picked up there by Weebler. He lost it, but Hickey keeps it in. Puck behind the net. Hansen tried to get it out front, and Ali makes the stop, and he'll hold on. Minute and a half left in the power play now. 12:51 left in the first period. Riders up 1-0. Back to the point. Hickey on the power play gets it to Jurek, puts it wide of the net. Puck comes back out front, but Joey just knocks it to the corner. Now Godfrey pulled down. Going to be another penalty here. Ali out of his net for the extra attacker. Now Birkebeil is going to call the 5th penalty of the night, and the game is not 8 minutes old yet. Off the draw, Downey on the 4-on-4 situation, wins the faceoff, back to Robbie Godfrey. Godfrey tried to put it to Murphy, but it went past him. Went off the stick. Now knocked down just outside the blue line by Justin Hillier. Hillier winds up for a shot. Ali makes the stop. Rebound cleared away by Jim Murphy. Just in time. Now Jurek fires it back in, gets past Popadich and in deep. Murphy heads behind his net, tries to get away from Kilhoma, put a pass up for Downey, but it went past him. Now Kramer Hickey has it off the backhand, stopped in front by Godfrey. Godfrey sends out the boards for Popadich. Now picked up by Downey. He's 1-on-1. Downey in over the blue line. Downey gets around his man, but it's swept away at the last minute. Now Brett Downey behind the net in a 1-on-3 situation. Can't pick up the puck, but doing a lot of good forechecking and making it tough for Justin Hillier to get out of his own zone, but he gets it to Kramer Hickey. Why not captain? Just rips it in on net. Ali kicks that out. 24 seconds left on the 4-on-4, and the Riders will go on a short power play. Coleman in over the line, a shot wide of the net. Pishaya picks up the rebound that came off the backboards. Puts it across to Cullen, who shoots, and S made the stop. I think Cullen was surprised by that pass a little bit, hesitated a bit before he shot. Just 12 seconds after the 4-on-4, then the Riders go on the power play. Back to the point, Stout takes it off the faceoff, dumps it deep into the corner for Robinson. Robinson takes a bump from Sando. Now in to help out is Scott Roger. Muskies get out of their own zone. Now the Riders on the power play. A shot. Ali kicks out. Robinson picks it up. Now a power play for Fernie. Robinson. It's up through center. Palmer and Hughes following him. Robinson spins off to the sideboards, gets it back to Godfrey at the point. A shot deflected by Palmer, just wide. Palmer goes in behind the net. Hughes comes in to help out. Creates an odd man situation behind the net, and Riders come out with the puck. Robinson off the sideboards. Back to the point to Stout. Back to the sideboards to Robinson. Gets shot towards the net, tipped again, but wide. Connor Hughes now will put it back to Robinson on the far boards. Robinson steps up to the top of the circle, shoots it wide. Puck comes all the way out the other side. Now they're even. Riders now 0 for 2 on the power play. Muskies 0 for 3. Alex Stout keeps it at the blue line. Connor Hughes gets a shot. Backhand blockered away by S. Gaffney sends the puck off the boards out of his own zone. Johnson now along the boards. Takes a bump from Connor Hughes, but the Muskies get it out. Puck is rifled to center now. Cullen gets it back to the blue line to Hughes. Hughes just sends it in from McLeod. But the linesman blows the play offside. So we've yet to reach the 10-minute mark of the first period. Penalties already. 0 for 3 for Minot, 0 for 2 for Fernie. 10 minutes of power play time. We haven't played 10 minutes of the game yet. Of course, some of that time overlapping. That's how that math works. Puck behind the net now, McLeod. He'll bring it out the other side. Just sends a backhand through center to Kissick. Kissick gets to the line and dumps it in. Wasmuth and McLeod racing onto it. Wasmuth fanned on the shot. Puck comes back to the sideboards. Kept in the zone, though, by Wasmuth. Now Wasmuth knocked down. And we're going to see another penalty called here by Birkebeil. That's Eric Hellstedt who's going to get the penalty. Jan Pashea on the faceoff. Muskies control. Andy Jurek off the glass and down the ice.
Time of the penalty, 10-21.
Now Shane and Coleman here to get crossed up behind the net, but they get out. Chubotti now to Pashea. Pashea in over the line, nearly fell, but gets his run on one man, but the Muskies able to slam it back down the ice. Ali out of his net to leave it for Kyle Shane. Shane again playing the point on this power play. Normally a forward, but playing the point on the power play. Chubotti behind his own net sends it up to Shane, but it's too far for him, and the Muskies' Matt Hansen just dumps it back in. Dejanis gives chase. Two goals last night, one of them shorthanded, don't forget. Chubotti out of his own zone plays it to Connor Hughes. Hughes streaking up the right side, has the puck stripped from him, but Stout's there to follow up, shoots it just wide. Now Robinson one times the rebound, but it goes wide. Now Godfrey sends the puck in behind the net where Robinson was waiting for it. Back to the point, but Godfrey and Stout were changing spots on the blue line and went right between them. 51 seconds left in the power play now for the Riders. Third opportunity of the night. Connor Hughes brings the puck out of his own zone. Stick handles through center, gets it to Robinson. Robinson now to Hughes. One-timer went wide. Now Palmer off the sideboards. Back to Stout, barely kept it in. Palmer heads to it in the corners. The puck never reached the net. Now Connor Hughes takes the pass off his skate behind the net. Plays it cross ice to Robinson. Now Robinson to Godfrey. Two goals last night for Godfrey, both on the power play. Robinson tried to shoot towards the net. Jurek got in the way of that. Now Jurek pulls the puck back into the corner. 12 seconds left. I don't know if the Riders have gotten a shot on net. They put shots towards the net, but have they? I don't know if they've got one on net yet. There we are. Maybe a shot on net there.
Even!
Now the puck sent back down the ice. And as Robbie Godfrey picks it up, that puts the Ghost Riders 0 for 3 on the power play. Godfrey just backhands it deep behind the net. Ryan S. out. Loses the puck, though. Nearly gave it away right to Mark Wasmuth. Dejanis trying to catch up to that pass. Now Kissick and Wasmuth hope to make this a two-on-one, but quickly out of his own zone was Chris Henham. McLeod nearly sent Dejanis into another time zone there with that body check, but he missed him. Now Cullen takes the puck as Johnson lost it. And the puck goes off Dejanis and up into the stands. Now it looks like Johnson's going to get a penalty here, and Dejanis wants a piece of somebody. Luke Johnson continues to go after Ryan McLeod. Dejanis over talking to the referee about what's going on here. Well, I'm going to take a break as my voice seems to be going here until the puck is dropped.
Penalties on the play to Wendat Huskies. Number 19, Eric Johnson. 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. 2 minutes for roughing. And a 10-minute misconduct. The 2-minute minor is being served by number 17, Eric Larson. To the Ghost Riders, number 24, Ryan McLeod. 2 minutes for roughing.
Off the faceoff, Alex Stout carries behind his own net. He'll hang on there for Connor Hughes. Hughes gets the puck up to Rob Godfrey. Godfrey rings the puck around the boards, in behind the net. S, once again, nearly bothered by Palmer there, gave the puck to Connor Hughes. Back to the point to Stout. Stout cross ice to Godfrey, back to Stout. To Robinson, puts it back to Stout. Now Stout shoots, S kicks that out. Godfrey will pick it up on the near boards, dumps it back into the corner for Hughes. Hughes, near corner, tried to get it to Palmer, but it was picked off by the Muskies. Now Palmer battling in there to try to keep it in. Godfrey steps up on the play, hoping to keep it in. Aaron Dejanis sneaks behind him, so now Godfrey watches him, but Stout was back to cover anyway, so now Robinson able to bring it back in. Gets into the slot area, kicked out by S again. Palmer into the corner, behind the net for Hughes. Leaves it there for Robinson, back to the point to Stout. Right side boards, now Robinson. Heads the top of the faceoff circle, a shot just high and wide. Godfrey rushes to keep it in as the rebound came all the way back to the line almost. Now Palmer plays the puck back to Stout. Stout sideboards to Robinson. Dumps it back into the corner to Palmer. But a pass out front picked off by the Muskies and sent down the ice. 40 seconds left in the man advantage now. Alex Stout carries the puck up ice. Cross ice pass for Saylor just a bit too far, but he'll go in behind the net with Kramer Hickey. Now Hickey stick handling away from the forecheck of Jakob Koma. Outlet pass, Jim Gaffney brings the puck up ice. Gets in around Kyle Shane, and Gaffney put it through Ali and out the other side. Now Koma, hit from behind, no call. Gaffney carries the puck back into his own zone, 11 seconds left now. And Hickey just picks it up and sends it down the ice. Riders look like they're gonna go 0 for 4 here. Now Jakob Koma plays up to Chibati. Lost the puck. Pishaya chases it down. Kilhoma now has it. Gets it up to the blue line. A shot. Ali makes the stop and holds on to the rebound. As the team's now at even strength, Fernie 0 for 4 on the power play. Muskies win the draw, back to the point, a shot goes wide of the net. Now Brett Downey takes it off the backboards. Puck ricochets out to center. Kyle Shane couldn't knock down that clearing attempt. Murphy hammers his man. Nearly puts Eric Hellstead right into the Riders' bench. There! The Riders dump the puck down the ice on net. S has to make the stop. Now Popadich bothering his man along the far boards. Muskies pick it up, though. Garrett Larson brings it through center. Now gets it to Hellstead. Hellstead falls as he dumps it in. Godfrey behind the net. Left it, and Ali sent it the rest of the way. Now Downey puts up through the center to McLeod. McLeod out of the box, goes up over the blue line. A shot. Saves made. Now Murphy with the rebound, went off a skate and wide. Downey heads off the ice for the line change. So the Riders. Wasmuth, who just stepped on the ice, takes the puck at center. Stick handles into the zone. He's hauled down. Now Kramer Hickey's going to take another penalty. The eighth penalty called in this first period, and we haven't played 17 minutes yet. Riders already 0 for 4, and it's just the first period. Off the faceoff, puck comes back to the point to Godfrey, gets it back to Stout, a shot, doesn't make it to the net, and the puck is cleared. Juha Kilholma chases Rob Godfrey back into his own zone. Godfrey skates away from Kilholma behind the net, banks it off the backboards for Stout. Muskie's a little more aggressive on the penalty kill tonight. Last night they were all hanging back at the blue line, but tonight they're all in deep. Now they back off in a hurry as Alex Stout carries it out, gets a pass to Robinson, who chips it off the sideboards. Now Palmer in a foot race into the zone. Puck just rifled down the ice by Ryan S. Ali out of his net at the other end to settle things down. 3:11 left in the first. 1-0 Riders lead on that goal by Mark Palmer. Now Rob Godfrey out of his own zone. Carries a puck to the blue line. Passes up to Hughes. Takes the pass off his skate. Hughes gets in around his man. Now carries in behind the net. Dumped the puck to the sideboards. It was deflected by Kilholma. And now Kilholma gets around Stout. Stout's going to have to catch up to him. Kilholma on a partial. Nice play by Alex Stout. Kilholma had a good chance at a breakaway. Kilholma was standing in the crease. Now Hughes with in a three-on-two situation. Sends the puck to Robinson. Hughes breaking towards the net. Now peels off to the corner where the puck's going to go. Muskies instead send it off the sideboards. Robinson initially knocked it down. Now 41 seconds left on the power play. Chubotti back in his own zone. Both teams have been fairly ineffective on the power play tonight. No real good chances yet. Pechea takes a knee-on-knee hit. That's going to be a penalty. Give it up to the Muskies if I were you guys. 22 seconds left. Another penalty may be called on that play against Koma. Now a tripping penalty coming up. There could have been a slashing call as well. Why not? Two men short. Back to the point. Stout now off the faceoff. 13 seconds left in the two-man advantage. Koma, top of the faceoff circle. Now looks for it to get a shot. Puck bounces around in front, kind of like a pinball there. Now bounce down the ice. That'll do it for one penalty. Still a minute 43 left on the second one, though. Now Koma gets around one man. Puck squirts past Hickey, but Hickey able just to backhanded down the ice. A minute 28 left in the power play. Riders 0-5 on the night so far, working on their sixth man advantage. Alex Stout in over the blue line, puts on the brakes, now looks for someone to catch up. It's Rob Godfrey, who winds up and shoots, doesn't get it on net though. Pechea puts it back to him. Pechea now off the sideboards. Pechea skates away from his man, circling, gets it back in the corner to Wasmuth. Wasmuth brings it out front, shot in front of the net, rebound lying loose. It came to Alex Stout, but he wasn't in position and couldn't get his stick on it. Godfrey keeps it in now. Two Muskies head through center, though. Gaffney picks it up. Gaffney in over the line, in on Alex Stout, but Stout, good job there to keep the shot from getting on net. Now Godfrey brings it up ice. Muskies send the Riders back, though, to center. Now Stout plays it to Downey. Back to Wasmuth. Winds up. A shot. Rebound lying in the slot area. Another shot. They score! Rob Godfrey, his third goal in the last two games. All on the power play. Rob Godfrey now with three power play goals in the last two games. And Godfrey on the season has gotten himself all the way up to six goals now. So the Riders in the same spot they were last night with a 2-0 lead. Let's see if they can hang on tonight. Robinson missed the puck at center. Puck is sent in on Ali, and he'll just hang on.
Time of the goal, 19:24.
Ryan McLeod and Brett Downey get the assists on Rob Godfrey's sixth goal of the year on the power play.
See if
And Rob Godfrey put that where Ryan S. had no chance, right under the crossbar. 21 seconds left now. Minot, Inferni territory. Connor Hughes, though, gets the puck out. Knocks his man down as he gets over the blue line, but can't get past him. And Jurek, taken to the backboards by Palmer. Jurek nearly has his lid knocked off. Now the Riders have seemed to have taken some momentum out of that last goal, and they've really picked up their hitting. And that'll do it for the first period. So the score after one period of play, Ferny Ghost Riders 2, Minot Muskies no score. We'll be back in a blink with our second period.
right there and get him to wave at the camera. Everybody say, yeah! Wave at the camera, everybody. Good job, guys. Good job.
Welcome back to the second period. Shots after one period, 13-10 in favor of the Ghost Riders. Power plays already 1-for-6 for Fernie, just 0-for-3 for Minot. Muskies in Fernie territory. They'll come out with some fire in the second period, but here's Connor Hughes. He's going to get a breakaway if he can catch up to it. Hughes and Kramer Hickey battle for the puck. Hughes has to go into the corner. Hickey takes him out, but now he's bumped off the puck by Robinson. Now pass towards the net, picked off by Hickey. Outlet pass too far for Dejanis. Robbie Godfrey with one of the Riders' goals tonight.
Go.
Dumps it down the ice out of his net to play it. Was S. Minot behind their own net. Reverse the play off the sideboards. Dump it out to center. Now Godfrey has to smack it off the boards quickly as he was being pursued. Now Dejanis gets the puck in over the line. Dejanis steps around one man, gets a shot on net, and Ali will hang on. Or glove hand left, rather. U-Haw Kilhoma with Justin Hillier and Jim Gaffney off the faceoff. Puck gets back to the point. Now Kilhoma in front of the net, a shot. Ali kicks that out, and the puck was put back to the point with a high stick, but not called. Now the puck back to the near point. Deflected just wide through the crease almost. Now Gaffney plays it off the sideboards. Godfrey in to help out. Now Koma comes in. Now Koma and Kilhoma. Say that three times really fast. Koma into the corner with Kilhoma again. Dumps the puck behind the net for Murphy. Murphy spins away from his man, lays it behind the net, but just Muskie's there. And now the puck all the way down the ice. Sailor, Feller, he might have been able to chase that puck down the ice, but Chris Henham gets back first. Jan Pashaya bothers. Henham nearly takes the puck off him, but the pass is through center. Murphy picks it up. Backhands it off the boards through center now. Dumped back in by Dan Cohen. Jim Murphy picks it up. Rink-wide pass for Sailor. Sailor still out there with Coleman and Pashaya. Sailor gets it to Murphy. It's bouncing over his sticks. He just pushes it to the line. Now Sailor steps up into his man. Pashaya back on the defensive. Tapped it up to Coleman, but couldn't handle it. Now a shot in. Ali will stop that. Murphy picks it up as Ali dropped it in front of the net, and the puck goes all the way down the ice. It'll be an icing call unless Popovich can get there first, and that was close. Popovich, I think, did get there first, but Scott Roger got his stick on it first. Two and a half minutes gone in this second period. 2-0 Riders lead. Same lead they had last night before Minot came back and scored three straight. Riders definitely want to avoid that tonight. Popovich again on the hustle back into the offensive zone. Popovich, very, very good hustle. Since he's become a Ghost Rider, he's impressed me a lot with how much he's always 100% on every shift. You can see he's obviously an intense player. Now Ryan Cullen, very lucky to get away with that as Cullen took a hit and turned around and took a swat at somebody. Cullen very lucky not to be called on that. Now the play whistle dead. Looks like Ryan Cullen is going to be called now. 15 penalties called in this game, and we're just under 3 minutes into the second period. Very chippy game tonight, these two teams developing possibly a bit of a rivalry. usually play fairly close games that are won late in games. I understand that was the case in Bozeman. I don't remember if that was the case in Bozeman. I remember the two games where we were at Minot, though. They were very close. Now Downey bumps his man. Popovich comes in to knock everybody else down. Riders get the puck to the line. Kyle Shane crossing with Popovich. They nearly run into each other, but they don't. And they end up getting it in. Now Downey bumps his man beside the net. Muskies get it up to center. Pass cross for Helstead. Helstead gets a shot. Ali makes the stop. Stout kicks the puck behind the net and plays up to his stick and up to Downey. Now Downey off to Shane. Shane's got Popovich breaking. He didn't see him. Shane did not see Popovich breaking down the right side, and he was gone in alone with nobody within 25 feet of him. If Shane would have seen him. Now Wagman can't get the puck through. Picked off by Kramer. Hickey, Minot captain to center, gets a shot in on Ali. He'll hang on to it and drop it in front of him. Play it there for Stout. Stout. Cross-ice pass by Wasmuth. Very ill-advised. I don't know what he was doing there. There was green uniforms everywhere. Now the Muskies with a bit of momentum here. Look to put the puck out front, but Ryan McLeod, who's having a good game so far, gets in the way of that. Now Chris Kisick will end up one-on-one, but Andy Jurek back into the corner with Kisick. Fights him off, but in comes Ryan McLeod to help out. Kisick and Jurek still battling behind the net. Kisick on the backhand gets a pass across to Wasmuth, but Wasmuth was just too far back of the net. Now Murphy plays the puck off the boards in front of the Minot bench. Gets a shot to push it in deeper, but finally the Muskies dump it back into Fernie territory. Dejanis just chips it into the corner, where Godfrey sends it back up the boards. Wasmuth can't get it out. Puck comes off the backboards. Starting to trickle out front, but Murphy got in the way of that. Now Wasmuth. It's a 3-on-2 here. Wasmuth has Palmer. Cross-ice pass for Palmer. Winds up a shot through traffic. Hit Wasmuth. Now a 3-on-2 developing into the Fernie zone. Dejanis back pass, but it was overskated. Shot on net, and Ali will hang on to it. It's Gaffney in front of the net looking for the rebound, but Ali held on. Shot now off the faceoff. Birkebeil makes no indication. Now Birkebeil is going to call a penalty here on the Muskies. It's going to go against Justin Hillier. Misconduct. Now Juha Kilhoma over to argue the call. Now Hillier in the box along with his buddy Eric Johnson. Goal light did not come on. Birkebeil says it's no goal. Muskies face off in the rider zone. Off the draw, look to get a shot, but can't do it. Now Palmer diving, gets the puck out. Palmer very good at that. When he dives, he usually gets the puck out. And now one of the Muskies hammered in front of the Ghost Riders bench. And he's hurting a little bit as Mark Lindgren was just tattooed. Connor Hughes bumps his man off the boards. Now Robinson pushes Kilhoma as he comes in on the forecheck. Hughes looks to tip it off the sideboards. Can't get it out, though. Now Hughes gets it back. Up through center. Hughes plays it to Palmer. Palmer's got Robinson catching up. Now Palmer down to the corner. Battles with Kilhoma. Out front to Hughes. Hughes on the backhand, and S made a stop. Rebound cleared away by the Muskies and brought up ice. Juha Kilhoma, Muskies' second leading scorer, but the leading scorer on this trip because Ludvik's not here. Brought the puck in over the blue line, but he was offside. this off just outside the Fernie line. Coma takes it off his skate. Coma's been quiet the last couple of games, an assist last night, but hasn't scored in a bit. And you know that'll be frustrating. Jakob Coma, who's a very, very talented offensive weapon. Now Coma into the offensive zone, behind the net. Pushed in the corner for Pashaya. Pashaya, Coma behind the net. Pass back and forth. Finally, Pashaya back to the point for Stout. Cross ice for Wagman. Wagman puts it towards the net, but it's off of a body in front. Now Pashaya, Coma, both behind the net. Muskie's able to get it up ice, though, out of their own zone with one quick pass. Eric Hellstead brings it up. It's off the skate of Alex Stout on the shoot-in, though. Now Pashaya battles with his mantle on the sideboards. Wagman into the corner with it. Dumps it off the boards for Pashaya. Gets up to Coma. Back pass to Stout. He's got Saylor and Coma with him. Saylor coming in, back to Stout, a shot. Just went wide of the net. Pashaya keeps it in on the sideboards. But now the Muskies on second effort get it down the ice. Murphy back in his own zone to pick it up. Dumps it off the boards, out through center. Now a pass through the middle. Stout cuts his man off, allows Downey to move up on the play. Now Kyle Shane with a puck in his skates, gets it to Popovich, who just pushes it into the zone. Kramer Hickey tried to get it out, but Popovich was there and kept it in. Hickey will try the other side now, but Popovich is right there again. Popovich, I mentioned it before, very intense and very hustle. Very good hustle from this 20-year-old. Started the season with the Great Falls Americans. Jim Murphy goes into the corner, battling with Mark Lindgren. Now the puck up ice. Downey chips it to Kyle Shane. Shane 2-on-1 with pass in front. And Godfrey couldn't quite pull the trigger there. Popovich goes to bump his man after the play. Murphy bumped off the puck. Now Godfrey, only man back, but Hellstead couldn't take advantage of that. Andy Jurek takes the opportunity to hit Kyle Shane at the end of the play. Now pass out in front. Bodies flying everywhere as Popovich came across the crease and fell. Now Jurek with a shoot in. And Ali will hang on. Now drops it free for Godfrey. Godfrey's got lots of room. Skates up to the faceoff circle. Now passes up to Downey, who just chips it down the ice on net. So S has to chip it to the corner. Now Kisik into the corner. Muskies just decide to flip it up and out of play. And there'll be a faceoff in Minot territory. 11:42 left in the second. Still 2-0 Fernie leads. Muskies right now getting frustrated. You can hear the chatter on the bench. You can see Ryan S. saying something to the official, and the Muskies are getting frustrated. You can see it. The Ghost Riders have to keep them that way. If the Muskies get a goal, it will add life. And the Ghost Riders would rather, believe you me, keep them this frustrated, because when you're this frustrated, you tend to not play smart hockey. And the Riders can take advantage of that all night if they just keep the Muskies back on their heels like this. Now the puck through center. Kisik nearly cuts off Kilhoma. And now the play back into the offensive zone was offside. And that'll bring the faceoff just outside the Fernie line with just over 11 minutes left. Still 2-0 Riders. Michael Goodwin in with you on this Kootenai Cable broadcast of the Fernie Ghost Riders and Minot Muskies. I think you can really see Juha Kilhoma. You can see when he picks up the puck, he's got some talent, but I have a feeling. And I can actually back that feeling up by remembering how these two played together in Minot when we were there. But Kilhoma, without his line mate and leading scorer, David Ludvik, is not the same player. Cullen, behind the Riders' net, sends it up the boards. Wasmuth can't get it out. Kept in at the point of shot. Ali kicks that out of play. There'll be a face-off in Fernie territory, probably to the blocker right of Ali. Kilhoma on the draw with Jeremy Robinson in Fernie territory. Robinson wins it back to Wagman. Stout swiped at the puck, and Ali did as well. And Ali got it to the point, and now it's finally sent out on second effort. Spinning at center was Cohen. Got the puck to Hellstead, who was bumped. Muskies gave up the puck, but got it back. Chris Henham plays the puck in his own zone. Hellstead just smacked out to Kilhoma, but it was too far, and Wagman picks it up. Wagman safely off the glass, out to center. Dumped back in by Henham. Wagman right back out. Now Hughes, or Robinson rather, heads up ice. I don't know how I got those two confused. Hughes was standing right in front of me there. Wagman out of the corner in his own zone, banks off the boards to Robinson. Tried to get it through his man to Hughes, who was breaking down the right side. Now the Muskies bring it back in quickly. Sando puts a shot wide of the net that Ali blockers to the corner anyway. And now a penalty coming up. tripping call. Looks like it's likely going to go against the Riders. They were the ones in possession when the whistle blew. Kilhoma will play the point on this power play. They'll have to watch him. That's where the pass comes right off the bat. A shot on net kicked into the corner. Now Eric Johnson back on after serving his misconduct and his two minors. On the power play. Riders can't get it out over the line, but now they can on second effort. Johnson picks it up though, now heads back in. Gets a shot on Ali and he'll hang on for the faceoff. It'll stay in Fernie territory. 9:44 left in the second, still 2-0 Riders. Colma, as he leaves the ice, just has that look on his face. Colma does not like it when he doesn't score. But you know that young man will break out of it. He is a heck of a talent. I don't know what his plans are, but it would be surprising to me if he was in this league next year. Maybe a shot at the USHL for Colma, or maybe the CHL. Now 9:18, maybe he'll be back here, who knows? Kramer Hickey can't handle a pass, cross ice, so Godfrey picks it up, plays it down ice, and Hughes helped it in, but now Ryan S. out of his own net, a minute flat left on the power play as the Muskies start up out of their own zone. Kilhoma picks up the puck from behind the net, drop pass, picked up there by Bryce Anderson. Now sent up ice for Degenis. Back pass to Hickey, a shot. Godfrey stopped that though, and the puck all the way back down the ice. Connor Hughes was wide open and nobody saw him. Now Palmer doing some good penalty killing there, causing some damage and getting the puck back down the ice. Palmer gets off now after a good strong penalty killing shift. Now McLeod and Wasmuth, diminutive penalty kill out there now. Both of them with amazing intensity though for the size of the players. I've said that all year long about these two. Warwick Wasmuth will not back down from a fight with anybody, and Ryan McLeod will go into the corner with anybody, as will Wasmuth. I've seen Ryan McLeod hit and be hit harder than anybody his size should ever be, and he's bounced back each time. A couple of injuries this year has kept him out of a few games, but very resilient. Now a penalty coming up against the Ghost Riders again. 14 seconds left in the first one. It'll be a two-man advantage for 14 seconds. The Riders would be very well off if they won this draw and just got the puck down the ice. There we go. That'll do it anyway. It won't kill off the entire first penalty, but it'll kill off some of it. Muskies will have a chance to get up ice. 3 seconds left. Now just 1 second. Now the Riders just down one man. Wegman gets back into the play. He has to hurry. Now Wegman back into the play. So officially a 5-on-4 now. Good hustle by Tyler Wegman, and he gets the puck down the ice. Minot now 0-for-4 on the power play. Now Cullen with a shot, goes wide of the net. Palmer comes out. Palmer doing a good job on the last penalty kill, so he's back out for this penalty kill. Penalty killing specialist last year too, from what I understand. I wasn't here, but I hear the stories. Now the play in Fernie territory. Minot on the power play for another minute and 7 seconds. Pass out in front. Rebound is loose. Ali's down. Puck is still loose. And finally, dumped down the ice. And we're going to get another penalty call here. And it's going to go against Jim Gaffney, I think. I think Gaffney's going to get it. I don't know if Birkebile is going to call Ali for the shot that he gave Gaffney, but he might. No, just the one penalty. So that makes Minot officially 0-for-5 on the power play. It'll be too late by the time this airs, but
you'd be dead by then.
These Kootenay cable people, I don't know what the heck they're up to. Andy Jurek behind the net with Pashea. Yuha Kilhoma comes away with the puck. Now picked up by Eric Johnson. Johnson brings the puck up ice with speed, tries to get around everybody but can't. Now Ali makes a stop and a rebound. Pulled in right away by Ali as well as Juha Kilholma was there in front of the net. Now Murphy does a little jousting with Kilholma. And I'm not sure that's a battle Kilholma wants. But again, I've said it before, I'm kind of biased. I don't think Murphy will lose to anybody in the league. Great guy off the ice, intense on the ice. Ghost Rider veteran in his last year of Junior A eligibility. And I'm glad I got to see him play. Not a flashy guy, but every once in a while, if you remember, there's a couple of times when, like that overtime game against Great Falls, I think the first time when Murphy put a pass across to Jakob Kolma that was just amazing. Now the Riders into the zone, 4-on-4. Cross ice pass for Godfrey, comes off the boards. Now deep into the corner, Kolma tries to pick it up. Now Pashea, backhand pass out front, nobody was there. Murphy dumps it into the corner. Just 11 seconds left on the power play now. Now Johnson moves up ice. Murphy looks to cut him off. Johnson can't get around Murphy. Nice solid play there. Now Jurek picks the puck up at center. 1 second left in the 4-on-4. Now the Riders with a man advantage for another minute. So this is Fernie's seventh opportunity with the man advantage. Connor Hughes chases the puck into the offensive zone with Andy Jurek. Connor Hughes wins that battle, gets it to Robinson, sets up on that familiar spot in the sideboards. Robinson right side, back to the point. Nice saucer pass to Stout. A shot just went wide. Now Stout races to keep it at the far point. Just kept in. Stout puts a shot on net. It went wide. Now Robinson sets up on the sideboards again. Robinson waits for somebody to come out front. Gets it to Connor Hughes. Hughes shot. S made the stop. S Club. I won't sing anymore. Alex Stout behind the net for Connor Hughes with 16 seconds left on the power play. Gets around the first man, now decides to carry in over the blue line. That'll probably put the Riders offside though, as he was stopped. Still time for one more rush if they hurry. 7 seconds left. They should be able to get up past the midway point before Minot becomes even anyway, and they do. Now Connor Hughes brings it in, gets it over to Robinson. Robinson back to Hughes, a shot, and S makes the stop.
Please register at the poster table in the lobby. Have a happy birthday wish to pass along. Happy 19th birthday to Matt Wozniak.
Now Chibati from the point gets a shot that's high and wide. Wozniak out front, tipped in front by Kissick, just wide. Now Kissick battling hard behind the net, look to get the puck out front again. Can't get it past Hellstead though, who brings it up ice and dumps it in. Now Cullen being chased back into his own zone by Corey Leonardson. Now the puck picked up there by the Muskies. McLeod knocks his man off stride though. Now pass out front. Kissick can't quite catch up to it before it's picked up by Adam Sando. Good opportunity there for a breakaway, but didn't materialize. Cullen sends it back in the corner. Nobody there but Hellstead. All the Riders are going the wrong way on that play.
Get in there!
Now McLeod goes into the corner with his man. Maybe we'll see a McLeod hit, but no, just rides him out of the play. Muskies with some puck possession here as they have the Riders pinned in a bit, but finally the puck sent down ice. Kissick gives chase. Puck sent back down into the Riders' zone. Ali out of his net just to clear it around the boards, all the way up to Wozniak. McLeod taps it right back to Wozniak. Wozniak gets around one man. It looked to me like that was a knee stuck out by Troy Weebler, but no call. Now in the Minot zone, won by the Ghost Riders. Godfrey will get a shot on net. The puck bounces and S just drops down on top of that. And he'll make the stop with just under 4 minutes left in the second period. 2-0 Riders still lead. That'll bring the faceoff deep into Minot territory to the glove hand left of Ryan S. Kyle Shane taps it back to Godfrey, who gets a shot, and S just kicks that into the corner. Now Popadich comes in, sends it behind the net, goes after it himself. Now Shane out front. Downey got a shot away, but the puck bounced straight up in the air as it was deflected. Now Popadich under the sideboards, battling there with Troy Weebler. Now the puck up ice, sent in deep. Chased down by Mark Lindgren. Pass out front, went off the crossbar. Muskies come close there on a breakdown on the Riders' zone. Now Godfrey plays the puck behind the net. Minot seems to be gaining momentum here. Kyle Shane tried to get it to Popovich, went off a stick and nearly got to Downey, though. Now Shane bodies his man off the puck. Puck frozen along the boards, finally pulled free by Downey. Downey gets it to Popovich and just pushes it in. Popovich can't get around his man at the blue line. Borderline interference there by Mark Lindgren. No call. Now the Muskies at center with just over 2 minutes, or just under 3 minutes, rather, left in this second period. Still 2-0 Riders. Fernie could certainly use that third goal here. Brett Downey now down the far boards. Andy Jurek cuts him off. Sater follows up, though, pulls the puck free, dumps it into the corner, and pulls it out himself. Now up ice is Jim Gaffney. Gets it through the middle to Juha Kilhoma. Catching up on the play is Justin Hillier. Kilhoma trying to get it to him. Hillier kicks it towards the front of the net. Now there's a Minot player in the net. And Ali was run over. Is Ali okay? Seems to be. Alex Stout off the draw, chased behind the net, but gets it to Wagman. Wagman has a puck taken off him by Gaffney. Helstead behind the net now. Tries to get around Robinson. Robinson pulls him down, but no call. Hillier, rather, now off the sideboards. Kilhoma back to the point to Jurek, a shot. Ali made the stop. It's lying on the goal line. Now the net's off its moorings. Gaffney and Wagman eye each other up, and Ali has been facing a lot of Minot traffic in front of the net. Kilhoma and Robinson on the draw, now in Fernie territory. 2:08 left in the second, 2-0 Riders still lead. Now Riders get it back to the point, but Jurek picks it up there. Palmer intercepts a pass into the slot area, though. Now Jurek, very strange skating style for Jurek, but he gets to the puck first as he kind of waddles to it. Now miscommunication between Ali and Godfrey nearly cost the Riders another goal, and they've been getting sloppy here. They're going to get burned if they're not careful. The Muskies have come close a few times here, and the Riders have got to pick it up. This is what happened last night. Minot looked like they started to take over, and Minot quickly found themselves with the next three goals. But here's Connor Hughes. Gets a puck out front. It's lying loose. Palmer took a swipe at it, but now the Muskies have it. Hillier brings the puck up ice. Robinson sweeps off his stick, though. Hughes has it, and backhand off the boards. Gets it to Kramer Hickey. Back in his own zone in Minot territory. Hickey behind the net. Minot captain. Looks to set something up. All three Ghost Riders inside the blue line, so they pass by all three of them out to center, but Godfrey chips it back to the blue line. Now Robinson has it, just dumps it in deep. Sailor will go in after it. Now Pashaya and Coma come over the boards to join Sailor. Muskies give the puck away at center. Murphy picks it up and just chips it back to the blue line, but Jurek got in the way of that and deflected it up over the glass. Faceoff should stay just outside the Minot line. Now Coma off the draw. Riders control. Chubati smacks up to the blue line. Mercedes gets it the rest of the way out. Sando gets it to Cohen. Cohen just bounces one in on net. Nali has it and holds on. Chubati comes in to pull Eric Johnson out of the way, and Johnson was the guy who lost it earlier and got himself a misconduct. Now Wasmuth on the faceoff, wins it to Murphy. Murphy smartly off the sideboards, and McLeod just sends it the rest of the way. 30 seconds left, Kisik. We'll get to it first, so that makes Ryan S. decide. He wants to come out. Now Wasmuth shoots. Blocked in front. Is Wasmuth ever going to get a break on a shot on net? Now McLeod just inside his own blue line. Gives it up at center. Muskie's come back the other way. Now sent back into Muskie's territory, though, or just outside the blue line. Anyway, Kissett couldn't do anything with it. Now they'll get a second chance to dump it in. Gets it inside the line with 4 seconds left. That should do it for this period. Murphy just dumps it in, and that'll end the second with the Riders still maintaining that 2-0 lead. We're back in a blink on Kootenay Cable with the third period of this game between the Ghost Riders and the Minot Muskies. Hopefully, Riders can hold on to this 2-0 lead. We'll finish off after this. Welcome back to the second period. Shots in that period, 13-10 in favor of Minot. Two period total now of 24-23. Riders get in right off the draw. Chance for Hughes out front as he's hauled down. No call. Rebound still loose. Palmer whacking away at it, but Minot Muskie's able to get it to the sideboards. Now Hughes again finds himself with a chance out front. Palmer swipes at it on the backhand and missed. Now Kramer Hickey brings it out, but the Muskies are going to be called. Dejanus gives Hughes a shot. Wasmuth on the faceoff just inside the line, but puck sent down the ice off the faceoff by Johnson. Riders out of their own zone. Ryan McLeod passes up to Chubotti. Chubotti brings in over the line. Skates behind the net. Riders defensemen doing some, getting a little deeper than I've seen them get in a long time. Robbie Godfrey's gotten a couple of goals that way. Now McLeod tries to tuck it in the short side. And Ryan S. drops down on that. Riders defensemen pinching down deep on the power play. Normally you don't see them do that, but the last few games they have, and they've gotten power play goals in two straight games now at home. One against Bozeman, two last night against Minot, one here tonight against Minot. We'll see if Rob Godfrey pinches down again. Back to the point for Godfrey, though, and he has to deal with the fact that Jim Gaffney got the puck out by him, so he'll head back into his defensive role. Now Stout leaves the puck for Hughes. Hughes gets around one man. Hughes up the middle, moves to the right side now. Dumps the puck in behind the net. Palmer will chase it to the other corner. Back to Hughes. Back behind the net to Robinson. Back around the boards to Stout. Good puck movement here by the Riders. Back to Palmer. Palmer back to Stout. Has some room. Decides to shoot, but it's blocked. Now Palmer winds up. Deflected. Went wide to the sideboards. Godfrey just taps into the corner. Now back to the point. Godfrey, a shot. Blocker to the side. Now another opportunity to get it out, but the Muskies can't again. Stout moves in to keep it in. Gets it down low to Robinson on the sideboards. And the puck went off a Muskie player and into the crowd. So the faceoff will be to the glove hand left, deep in the Minot zone. Now the puck rifled down the ice. Ali. Leaves it behind the net for Stout, and now some. Coma against Kilhoma. Coma wins the draw. Now Stout carries it out of the zone, gets up to Pechea. Pechea along the blue line, still with possession, but put himself offside, and that'll be a faceoff just outside the line. Just 17 seconds left in the power play now. 17:50 left in the third period. Riders still up 2-0. Now the puck off the sideboard. Stout chases it back into his own zone. Ali Sees there's 10 seconds left and lets his team know by smacking his stick on the ice. Now Coma brings the puck out of his own zone. Gets the play up to Chubotti, who chips it to Saylor. Saylor sends it to Pechea. Pechea in now, hard on Kramer. Hickey hammers Hickey into the backboards. Coma takes a pass off his skate, but picked up there by Kilholm and brought to center. Rifles it in high and wide. Now Pechea pulled down by Jurek, and Jurek's going to go to the box. Palmer, Hughes, and Robinson out on this power play, along with Stout and Godfrey. Riders could really use that third goal. They were caught from two goals up last night, so maybe a bit of a mental help to get that third goal tonight. I don't think their confidence is necessarily shaken with a two-goal lead, but it would probably just help the psyche that extra little bit to get that third goal. Now Connor Hughes leading the rush up ice. Stick handles in over the line. He's had it since he's been in his own zone. Still with it. Now finally back to the point to Stout. Shot deflected wide. Connor Hughes behind the net. Banked off the boards to Godfrey. Godfrey down low to Hughes. Hughes nearly had it sent out past him, but Stout keeps it in. Now wrist shot deflected high and just wide. Now Godfrey pushed up against the boards. Muskies try to clear, but they leave the puck in the corner. That gives Robinson a chance out of the other corner. Stout back to Robinson. Robinson nearly loses out of the zone, but keeps it in. Cross the blue line to Stout. Down to Godfrey, top of the faceoff circle. Cross ice pass for Robinson. Moving the Muskies box around. Now Stout, shot, the scores! Alex Stout! I don't think anybody got a piece of that. I think that's going to be Stout's goal. If it is Stout's goal, Stout's fourth goal on the year, if it is indeed Alex Stout, and the Muskies are going to go right back on the penalty kill. It's going to be a bench minor. As Muskies head coach Chad Johnson said something to Birkabau that he didn't like.
Go Riders!
Where's the warning? Where's the warning?
So the power play right now, 2-for-9 for Fernie. They're about to go on their 10th opportunity right now. So that gives Robinson, by my unofficial account, 14 points in his last 7 games, and Connor Hughes, I think 10 points in his last 7 games. Second power play goal of the night for the Riders. They're up 3-0 now.
Go, go, go!
We talked about how important that could be to get that third goal. Now they're right back on the attack on the power play as Wasmuth comes in over the line. Wasmuth back to the point to Chubotti. Just dumps it back to the sideboards for Wasmuth, but it was dumped out over the line, hit the linesman, so didn't get all the way down the ice.
Go!
Now Wasmuth brings it back in, tried to get it across from McLeod. Kramer Hickey in there to stop things. Now Ali out of his net, 1:10 left in the power play, 15:18 left in the third period. Riders up 3-0. Now McLeod, pass to Godfrey in his own zone. Godfrey played the puck up to center. McLeod chases Hickey in his own zone. Hickey can't get it out as McLeod just held his stick enough. Now McLeod behind the net to Downey. Downey to Godfrey, pinch down low. Godfrey with a shot. Near side blocker save. Downey, down low to McLeod. McLeod out front. Wasmuth had a chance there, but Eric Johnson got in the way of that at the last minute. Mark Wasmuth, if he had any luck, no, if he didn't have bad luck, it'd be no luck at all for him. Now Connor Hughes brings the puck up ice into the offensive zone. Palmer and Robinson following up. Hughes carries behind the net. Robbed out of the play by Jurek. Palmer comes in to help out. Comes free with the puck. Gets it to Robinson. Robinson fanned on it, but got it back to Stout anyway. Stout has to come down the boards to pick it up. Now Robinson battling in the corner, being bothered again. Just 4 seconds left on the power play. Now the puck back to the point, though. Stout gets it down to Robinson. Top of the circle, a shot. Deflected, bounced on net. Now another opportunity, but the Muskies pick it up and bring it up ice. Dejanis, 2-on-2, just decides to rifle it into the corner. Stout will be there first. Gaffney after him. Sando can't get the puck in deep, and the Riders get it back out. Hillier gets across ice to Gaffney. Gaffney got a shot on net. It was kicked out by Ali. Now the rebound. Popovich being grabbed onto. Finally let go of. Now Robinson. Shot from the slot area. Just got to the heel of the stick on the puck and not a hard shot. Easily handled by the goaltender. Now Murphy gets a shot on net. Deflected but wide. Now Pashaya gets it down low to Popovich. Popovich banks it off the backboards. Pashaya and Downey go in after it. Puck bounces up high. Lands underneath Popovich. But the puck was in the equipment of Dejanis. So the whistle goes. Muskies bring the puck up ice. Justin Hillier tried to get around Chibati. Chibati got a piece of him. Shot on net was broken up by Cullen. Now Downey, 3-on-2 through center. He's got Chibati and Pashaya with him. Downey to Chibati. Oh, nice shot by S. The rebound just put wide. Chibati falls in the corner. Now gets back up a shot. Another rebound goes wide of the net. Kilhoma battles for the puck along the near side. Popovich gets it to Downey. Now Downey back to Popovich. Looks back to the point to Cullen, but can't move the puck as the Minot Muskies are on him on the near boards. Finally picked up there and brought out by the Muskies over the blue line. Justin Hillier. Chibati, the man who had that glorious opportunity just a couple of moments ago in his own zone, plays up to Popovich off the boards, gets up to McLeod. Now McLeod carries in 1-on-2. Can't go anywhere with it. Riders are changing, so the Muskies bring it up ice. Wagman tried to hip check but missed. Now the Muskies still with the puck, and Ali makes a stop and hangs on. With 12:11 left in the third period, Kilhoma has not been dangerous the last couple of games, but nonetheless, still their second leading scorer. So coincidentals. Off the faceoff, puck is deflected high, goes into the mesh behind the net, and that'll be a faceoff. Inferny's net at Inferny's zone again. And we did mention for Stout on the year, that is his fourth goal. So a lot of Riders defensemen getting on the score sheet in the last couple of games, and that's not typical. Riders D doesn't score a lot of goals, but that's four of them in the last two games now for the Riders defense. Now Palmer calmly takes the puck that was headed for the front of the net and just lofts it down the ice, S out of his net, plays it around the other boards. Palmer steps in the middle of that play, though, and breaks it up. Now Connor Hughes will get to it first, likely back in the corner. That's where he goes. Palmer throws a hit at his man. Nice hit by Palmer. Now Wagman from the point gets a shot. It flutters on net. Rebound to Robinson. And the puck is held on to by Ryan S. If I was Jeremy Robinson right now, I'd look right into his face mask and start singing, S Club, gonna blow it by you. Oh, maybe not. I don't know how good a singer Jeremy is. off the draw now. Popovich gets a backhand shot on net. Ness had a bit of trouble with that. But the S Club got his pad down on that and kept the puck out. Now the puck in the corner. Minot Muskie's two at first. Rebound lying in front of the net, but Downey cleared it away. Now Jurek and Downey. Their sticks collide, and the puck shoots up straight in the air, lands on the other side of the ice, and Pechea tries to get it out. Kept in there by Hellstead. Now Pechea is able to get it out, though. Pechea up ice. Gets around one man in front of the net. Pechea couldn't hang on to the play, though. One of the Muskies has broken their stick. Now Murphy off the boards. Dumps the puck in deep. Jurek behind the net, spins away from Downey. Downey gives him just a little bump behind the net. Pechea steps in front of the breakout opportunity, and Muskies just go across to the other side. Chibati carries his man behind the net with him. Puck is still there, though. Now Chibati back to help out again. Ali got his paddle down to stop that pass out front. Now Popovich at the point, gets knocked down. Muskies with some pressure here in Fernie territory. Dejanis now in front of the net. Ali makes a save, another save. Ali was down. Muskies again from the side of the net. The Riders having trouble controlling Minot here. Just 9:59 left in this third period. 3-0 Riders lead, but the Muskies pressing in a big way here. And you can see that coming from a mile away. Dejanis gets a stick on that pass out front and breaks Joey Jamal Ali's shutout. For Dejanis on the year, his 9th goal. Now a 3-1 game in favor of the Ghost Riders. That shift was chance after chance after chance for the Muskies. And Dejanis finally buries it. And you know, I was starting to think shutout in my mind, but there was no way I was going to use that word throughout this entire broadcast. Just not to jinx Ali. Robinson pulled down. This is going to give the Muskies some momentum. You know that. So the Riders have to come out on this shift and really answer that momentum. Connor Hughes, he's a guy who can do it. Very talented player. Brings the puck to center. Chips it off the boards. Robinson does. Down to the corner for Palmer. Puck's on the back of the net. And they'll call the play dead. Off in Minot territory. Robinson chases his man into the corner. Good shift here by the second line. Maybe some people call it the first line. Wagman has the puck bounce over his stick, though. Kilholma chases him back into the zone. Hellstead can't dump it in, though. Or Hillier, rather. Play was offside, but now they clear in time and they get it back in. Stout just flips it up over the glass, not a play. So that's going to be a faceoff in Fernie territory. Ghost Riders have to match the intensity of the Minot Muskies here. Blowing a 2-goal lead last night was probably disheartening. And I tell you right now, I know. I mean, it's an obvious without even saying it anyway, but let me just reinforce that the Minot Muskies are back in this game now, and the Riders do not want to blow a 3-goal lead. Ali makes the stop into the corner. Godfrey dumps the puck along the boards, but it's sent back behind the net, and the Riders look like they could be on their heels here in their own zone again as the Muskies are flying. Now Kilholma behind the net, spins away from his man. Godfrey and McLeod converge on him. Godfrey gets the, McLeod gets the puck to the point. Now the Muskies are going to get another penalty, though. It's a slashing call. So Jim Gaffney's going to go to the box with 8:41 left. So the Riders on the power play for the 11th time tonight. Right now, 2 for 10. And Kilholm off the faceoff, brings the puck in offside. The faceoff, Riders control. 8.5 minutes left in this third period, minute 51 left in their power play. They'll start things up from their own zone. Alex Stout behind the net, crosses with Connor Hughes. Now plays the puck up to Robinson, rink wide for Hughes. Hughes pressured by Hickey, and Hickey keeps the puck in the zone. Now Godfrey out of the corner, played it past Stout into the corner for Robinson. Muskie's very, very aggressive on this power, on this penalty kill rather. Now Godfrey loses the puck, and here's Kilholm with a chance. It's a good thing Stout got his stick in the way of that, as the Riders right now are backing off and they're letting down. This two-goal lead is not safe, boys. Let's pick it up. McLeod off the draw. Kept into the point by Hickey. Pass back to the point of shot. Who's got the power play here? Wasmuth got hit as he took the puck into the corner. Now Hickey pushed into the boards by Stout. Wasmuth gets back up. Riders can't get anything going here on the power play. Now McLeod finally comes out the other side with just 1:04 left. Again, the Muskies, though, nearly keep it in. Now McLeod gets it to Wasmuth. Wasmuth with a shot, rebound. And S stops that. Now back to the point, Chibati gets a shot, and that's blocked. I think Ryan S is hurt. So S is back up now, maybe giving a little bit of a flack to Birkebeil. Only 48 seconds left in this power play now. The Riders, they could sure use another goal here again to bring back that 3-goal lead. Wouldn't it be nice if it came from one of their defensemen again on the power play? Actually, doesn't really matter who scores the damn thing, just as long as it goes in. Godfrey back in his own zone. Backs off of the forecheck. Leaves it for Connor Hughes. Hughes has room to skate it out. That's what he'll do. Godfrey took a slash. He went down. So he gets himself off the ice. And now Chibati comes on. Stout peels away from the forecheck. Gets it up to Chibati. Chibati off the boards. Jurek tried to keep it in. Now Palmer fighting to get it out. Stout has it. Just 13 seconds left. Now Robinson, it would have been a two-line pass had it connected. Just 5 seconds left in the power play now. Robinson should be first man to that puck. Stout now off the sideboards. Back to Robinson. Lots of room to get it out. Decides to go cross ice to Chibati. Chibati carries up ice. Sends it down the ice behind the net for Connor Hughes, but he couldn't catch up to it. That's going to be a face-off back in Fernie territory. 6.5 minutes left, and the Riders did not look good on that power play. They got to keep this intensity up because Minot's going to be coming at them. Wasmith on the draw. Riders win it as Ryan Cullen gets possession. Now Kisick tries to get it out, but can't. Cullen swiped out of his glove, but couldn't pick it up. Now the Muskies dump it in behind the net. Two riders there, but the Muskies are going to come in to make it difficult, and they do end up with possession. Now Wasmith battling with his man in the corner. Muskies trying everything they can here to get back into this game. They are in this game, don't get me wrong, but to get that second goal and bring it to within one goal, Jurek bounces the puck off the boards, but the Muskies are back in their own zone. Garrett Larson sends a puck up through center to Matt Hansen. Hansen stops at the blue line. McLeod took the puck off his stick and just gets out over the blue line, and now a hand pass. We'll whistle the play dead. Off the drop, puck is in skates just outside the line, and Godfrey finally picks it up and just chips it down the ice on net. So icing waved off. Under 6 minutes left now, just 5:40 left. Muskies bring it up through center, but it was too far for everybody, and Godfrey has it. He'll just ring it around behind the boards. Behind the net, rather. Can't do anything behind the boards now, can you? Now Pashaya has it. Pashaya up ice. Tries to get around one man, now gets in behind the net. Lots of traffic in front. Pashaya brings up front, shoots, he scores! Jan Pashaya! And Ryan S. is incensed. S. Club! Gonna score on you! And for Jan Pashaya, his 16th of the year. That goal coming at the 14:42 mark. And I haven't seen Jakub Koma in quite some time. I don't know if maybe Koma's hurting or whether he's been asked to sit down for a spell. Now the linesman over saying something to the official. Would they wave this goal off this late? I don't think so, but I saw that happen in, where was that now? Might have been in Bismarck, actually. Or mine, it could have been in Minot as well. It's really too bad that one is up on the board for the Minot Muskies. Joey Jamal Ali, another one of those Ghost Riders. He just great kid, absolutely enjoyable to talk to. So an unassisted goal for Pashaya. Now the referee waiting for someone from the Muskies to go over and serve the misconduct to Ryan S. The face-off. Muskies look to bring it in, but the Riders able to get in on a two-on-one. Now to Pashaya. He's in alone again. Now Downey can't quite put it in on the backhand.
Hello, Downey!
Downey giving a bump as he tried to stop Adam Sandoval coming out from behind the net. Now Murphy has the puck bounce over his stick. Chase back into his own zone. Given a bit of a hack by Bryce Anderson. Now the puck knocked down in front by Digenis, but the Riders able to get it out as Pashaya ducks as the puck lofts over his head. Now Connor Hughes, Jeremy Robinson line comes out. And Popovich will get off the ice. That means Palmer will probably come on. And an icing call on the Riders. 4.5 minutes left in the third period. Riders up 4-1. Stout out of his own zone, chips the puck off the boards, and the puck gets down the ice. Connor Hughes in a race with Kramer Hickey. He should win that easily. Hughes got there first, but Hickey outreached him. So with 4:20 left, the Muskies are pulling their goaltender. Down by 3 goals. I mean, they always say, what are you protecting? A 4-1 deficit? So the Muskies hoping to get something going here. Riders will have an empty net to shoot at, but you don't want to get too many icing calls doing that either. Wagman rings it around the boards, but can't get it out. Pass Justin Hillier. Shot on net goes wide. Puck comes back all the way to the far point. Kept in. Now a penalty coming up, it looks like, to the Ghost Riders as Tyler Wagman touches it. It's going to be a penalty for cross-checking. So Alex Stout's going to go to the box. It's going to be a 6-on-4 situation. Just 4:05 left in the third period. Now S goes back in. So Connor Hughes and Mark Palmer out to kill off the penalty. Minot's sixth opportunity on the night. Minot Muskies win the draw. Kramer Hickey gets it cross ice. No clear shot, so the Muskies had to dump it into the corner. Now Palmer's going to pick it up. Palmer just backhands it up to Connor Hughes. Bounces over his stick, and Hickey will take over. Pass cross ice for Hillier. Palmer couldn't stop that rush from coming up ice. Now Kilhoma loses the puck to Hughes, though. Hughes just decides to lift it down the ice. Good, smart play by the veteran. Back in his own zone is Chris Henham. U-Hawk Kilhoma for the Muskies brings it out. Kilhoma took a bit of a stick in the face, I think. I don't know if that's where it caught him. It looked like it might have. Now the Muskies with a shot. Ali makes a stop. The rebound's lying loose, and Ali has it. He'll hang on. Now some pushing and shoving in front of the net. With a minute left, minute 11 left on the power play. Kilhoma goes over to show the ref that he looks like he's going to say he did get a stick in the face. It looked like he did, too. But the Riders got away with that one. S comes back to the bench with a minute 11 left. So the Riders once again will have an open net to shoot at, and they can fire away because they're shorthanded. Murphy smacks it off the boards. Kept in at the point, shot, kick to the corner. Muskies look to set up. It's a 6-on-4 as the goaltender's out at the far end. Puck gets out over the blue line. Robinson quickly on Chris Henham. Now Dejernis at center. Passes through Pashea. Muskies get in over the line. Sent right back out, though. And now Robinson can shoot at that empty net, but can't get a good enough wood on the backhand. Now 2:51 left. Just 46 seconds left on the power play. Johnson has the puck in the offensive zone. Gets it down behind the net to Bryce Anderson. Now Dejernis. Dejernis all the way back to the point. The puck goes all the way down the ice. Pashea in hard on his man. Chases him behind the net. Now the Muskies, Kilhoma, sends it back to Chris Henham. Just 19 seconds left on the power play. Kramer Hickey through center. Muskies break in left side, and now offside. U-Hawk, Kilhoma, and Connor Hughes do some chatting. The Riders have done a good job of keeping the Muskies frustrated. We talked about that when they were down 2-0. And when they scored that third goal, Minot had some life. But then the Riders, on an absolutely gorgeous effort by Jan Pashea, restored the three-goal lead. Now a backhand shot goes wide of the net. Cullen smacks it off the boards. Can't get it out. Connor Hughes tries on the second attempt. Gets it just over the line. That'll kill off the rest of the power play. Now Cullen has it. Can he shoot for the empty net? All the way down. Just missed. But in a race, Stouts there. Just missed again. Now Hughes into the corners. Net still empty. Now Stout has it. Oh, and Stout can't get it in there. Gaffney with... brings out of his own zone, hammered by Hughes. Puck comes to Chibati, fires it down the ice. Now Hughes takes a bit of a shot to the head. Now the Muskies bring it up ice. Shot at the side of the net, fanned on. Now Shane has it, backhands it down the ice. McLeod in a race. He's gonna go into the corner. McLeod hit hard. Now Kyle Shane in there. He's bumped as well. Minute 17 left. Net still empty. Now Cullen. Another chance at the empty net if he wants it. Decides to skate down the wing. Now a shot. Stopped in front. Muskies in their own zone. McLeod chases his man behind the net. Last minute to play in the third. Now a breakaway pass. In on Ali. What a stop by Joey Ali. Penalty coming up to the Riders. So with 54 seconds left, it's going to be a 6-on-4 opportunity again, but again, the Riders can fire away at that empty net. Adrian Chibati goes to the box now. Minot 0 for 6 on the night. Now the Muskies. Six of them in the offensive zone against four Ghost Riders. Downey. Draw control by the Minot Muskies. Johnson puts it back in the corner. Godfrey can't get it out. Now Downey tries to get it up the boards. Gets back to Hickey. Hickey will skate along the line and get a shot. Ali makes the save. Rebound cleared. Now Pashea shoots all the way down the ice. Downey chases Hickey back. No icing because they're shorthanded. Hickey gives it away to Downey. Downey, a knee on knee. And now Dejanis is going to go to the box. Downey gives him a bit of a shot. Minot Muskies now 0 for 7 on the power play. So 29 seconds left for the Riders. Still to fire away at that empty net if they want. Put Ryan S. back in the net. Muskies had one too many men on the ice there. Now just 26 seconds left in the game. Will something boil over here? There's been some talking between players. It'll be interesting to see if something does boil over. Maybe that's why Riders veteran Jim Murphy's out there. He can handle himself with the fists if he needs to. We've all seen that. Now just 10 seconds left. Murphy brings it up ice, just skates it down the ice. No chance for the Muskies here now as they just take the puck in their own zone. Dan Cohen brings it back up. Less than a second at the shot. And Ali makes that stop. And the Riders win it. Final score, Fernie Ghost Riders 4, Minot Muskies 1. Riders get 4 out of a possible 6 points this weekend. And that's what they needed. Good night tonight for the power play again, scoring 2 goals. A couple of defensemen get on the board again tonight, and Rob Godfrey and Alex Stout. And the Riders pull out a 4-point weekend out of a possible 6, which will move them 2 points closer to Kimberly and move them to 1 point back of Bismarck. We're back here I believe, next Friday. Let me just check the schedule here, our home schedule. We are indeed back here on Friday, February the 9th, when the Bismarck Bobcats will be in town. That'll be a huge game as far as the standings go. That'll do it for tonight. Michael Goodwin for Kootenay Cable. On behalf of my cameraman, Sean Petkow, good night from Fernie. Possible points. Just talking to Rob Godfrey, interviewed him after the game. He said that you know, they consider that successful. Talking to Todd Jones in the middle of the week, he said he just wanted his team to compete, but you got to like the 4 to 6 points.
Oh, definitely. He moves up in the standings. Everybody has to remember Bismarck lost as well, so that's a big plus, and Bozeman lost. So we moved ahead and we gained some ground from somebody, and that's what we wanted to do as well.
Nice to see the Riders get power play goals in all three games this weekend as well. Two goals tonight, two goals last night, just a single goal in Bozeman, but four of the goals were in the last two nights, all of them scored by defensemen. Defensemen scoring hasn't been one of our strongest suits. Our power play hasn't been one of our strongest suits, but both of those came together tonight.
Definitely, when you start getting your defense scoring, opens up a whole kettle of worms, moves the offense around, and that's what you want. You want the opposition worried about what's happening with the team that's coming at them. You don't want them just relying and thinking, oh, they're just going to get the offensive scoring from the forwards. If you get D-man scoring like we did in the last few days, see you guys. I lost track now. we get goals. And prime example, Rob Godfrey got three this weekend, and it's a big plus for us.
A key, and I said this during the broadcast, was when we were up 2-0, you could really see Minot start to get frustrated. Their goalie was ticked off. The guys on the bench were slamming their sticks. They were swearing. They went into the third, down 2-0. We scored that third goal, and that seemed to put frustration into kind of, can we come back from this? But almost when you saw that goal scored, you knew Minot's the type of team, if they're down by three and they get one, they're back in the game in a big way. And that goal by Jan Pichet was a key goal to give us back our three-goal lead.
Yeah, again, you got to remember, Minot was from Helena, and some of those players were with the Gold Rush, and one of them was Hillier. He was a big gun for the team, and he's a strong player. When he gets frustrated, he has that in the back of his mind about playing in Fernie, and I don't think that ever leaves, for sure. Jan Pasea was all over the ice. He was flying. He was really strong for us. And this kid, when he moves the puck, fantastic. Great, great concentration, great pressure, and he moved right in the front, and he's never going to miss at that angle.
Too bad for Joey Jamal Ali. I really wanted to get the shutout tonight. I didn't use the word in the broadcast. It started to creep into my mind about maybe 3 or 4 minutes before they got that goal. It crept into my mind, but I said, I'm not going to say that word out loud.
No.
And I made sure I didn't. If it was 2 seconds left faceoff in their end, I wouldn't have said that word out loud. Too bad. But Joey gives up 6 goals in 3 games, and that's probably the key to the two wins. But I asked Rob Godfrey again in our interview just now. I said, is inconsistency on the guys' minds? Because it looked like a good game against Bozeman, not such a good game against Minot, and then tonight another good game.
Yes.
Yeah. Again, it's just working up the bugs. We got to just fine-tune the edges on our team. And we always have to remember, the biggest thing that this team has to concentrate on is communication. And communication is the key to everything. When you're talking to one another, you know where the opposition is. If you don't talk to one another, you make bad mistakes and you could get goals scored against you.
I think, now I'm going to go out on a limb and say this because I remember talking to Rob Godfrey towards the end of the week, and his parents are in town. At least his dad is, anyway, and I think he was still here. So I think we got to give Mr. Godfrey an invite to come back whenever he wants, because Rob was good this week. I mean, outstanding, really. And I want to, we can finish off and sort of wrap everything up, but I do want to reiterate that again. It was nice to see, A, the power play click, and B, the defensemen do the scoring on the power play, because those are two things we haven't been real strong on. And we showed a team like Minot that when we play at our best, we can beat anybody in this league. And that's been the key all year long. And Todd said that all year long. We've been saying that all year long. It just it remains a factor of consistency. And I think if they had this kind of effort and the effort they had on Friday night every night, I mean, they're going to be dangerous in the playoffs.
Hey, you said it. We've beaten every team in the league except for Billings, and that's the next task we got to concentrate on.
And we see that
work
twice
hard
on the road.
Yes, we do. Hey, and if we can beat them in their arena, that's going to change and set the tone for everything when the playoffs do come up. When you want the opposition coming here and they're thinking, oh boy, we going to have one hell of a fight on our hands, that's what we want. And like you said, we work hard. We've beaten Great Falls. We've beaten Minot now. We've beaten Kimberly. Hey, it's everything's starting to show. We just got to fine-tune those edges. And like I said before, communication is the key.
So we finish off, we don't see Minot again. We finish off 2-3 against them on the year. 2 wins, 3 losses. Good game tonight to get these guys back on track. 1 point back at Bismarck now. 6 back at Kimberly. Kimberly does have the game in hand. Bismarck has 4 games in hand. but nonetheless, it was good to get those 2 points out of the way. We can pretty much wrap it up with that for tonight for the three-game weekend. But next weekend, Bismarck is in town. That is going to be a huge game. Everybody, get your butts in the seats. Cheer this team on. Let's give them some support. And if they can beat Bismarck, burn one of Bismarck's games in hand, and pull ahead of them, we're talking to maybe a bit of a race there.
Yeah, we're in the thick of it right now. Like, we've gained ground on Kimberly, we've gained ground on Bismarck. Hey, we're still in the hunt. Like I said before, we string a few wins in together, like 4 or 5, maybe even 6 straight victories, or stay well above 500 in this month of February, we definitely have a good chance.
That'll do it tonight from Fernie. The final score again, Minot loses to the Ghost Riders 4-1, and we frustrated them at the same time. We got to their goaltender, Ryan S., who has a good save percentage and a good goals against average this year, and I only sang S Club 3 or 4 times during the broadcast, so when I was a little bit taunting there, you couldn't hear me, but I thought I'd do it anyway. But that'll do it for tonight from Fernie. Be here next Friday night when Bismarck is in town. Riders need your support, and that's going to be a must-win.